Hello, and thanks for watching Proactive New York. I'm joined by Dan Matlow. He's the CEO of VitalHub. Dan, very good to meet you.
Thank you. Pleasure to meet you, Stephen.
So Dan, for viewers not familiar with the company, can you tell us more about VitalHub?
Yeah, we're a Canadian-based healthcare IT software. We're 100% focused on the software industry, really focused on two different areas. One is the ever-growing area of patient flow and operational visibility. So those are solutions that really help healthcare organizations understand the movement of their patients through analytics, as well as provide solutions to patients to help them navigate through these complex health systems and really increase capacity and throughput of those patients. Again, a very large issue of internationally of healthcare organizations. And then we have another side of research, which we call EHR case management, which is a full end-to-end ERP system for complex community care, large organizations that are looking to provide documentation and organization of their patients as they go through those organizations. So, that's essentially what our two areas are. We've grown through both M&A as well as organic growth, and we're internationally based with operations throughout the UK, Canada, the Mideast, and Australia that we have. So we like our organization very much and what we've done.
Give us an example of some of your big customers, Dan.
We're very big in the UK. We have solutions probably through 80% of the NHS. So we got solutions all through every major trust and organization through the UK. So, going through King's, which is a very big trust in the UK, right through to South Tees in the north, very too large, but anywhere within the NHS, we would do. In the Canadian marketplace, we would have large provincial engagements. Like we have a provincial deal with the province of Nova Scotia. We just announced a quarterback, a very large transaction for the province of Ontario for all 28 of their prison organizations with Solicitor General have brought it in on a provincial basis. And we're providing one solution that would encompass all the penitentiaries through all the province. So there'll be two examples of some of the larger organizations in the Canadian marketplace. Again, I think we're dealing with about 600 customers worldwide that would use our solutions in many different areas.
And Dan, do you see an increase in business since COVID-19? Because that really highlighted capacity issues within healthcare services.
Yeah, we had a pretty strong quarter in Q1 in the UK. We think that was attributed to COVID in a pretty serious fashion. COVID did bring focus on the need for patient flow. Capacity issues in emergency rooms and hospitals were always major issues. Hence, an issue that was always prevalent before COVID, and again, is prevalent after COVID with a backlog and will continue to be prevalent as we try to keep up with our healthcare systems. But patient flow is something that has always been an issue for healthcare. Technology has caught up to that. We know that we use analytics in airports, for example, in terms of how we keep flow going through airports. We know we keep analytics on any other type of factories and moving packages through things. There's no difference in hospitals and organizations. Moving patients effectively using technologies is a really good issue, and technology's caught up to that problem. And we have lots of different solutions to solve that.
You mentioned that you are very acquisitive as well as growing organically. So when you look for acquisitions, are you looking for complementary businesses or are you looking for supplementary businesses that take you into additional fields?
I think we're looking for both. We're really looking for complementary in those two areas of patient flow. There's a lot of different targets, but we're also looking for the ability to get into new geographies where we can really launch by making an acquisition and then bring other products into those geographies. So we do want to grow internationally. We think there's a big target market internationally of what we do. We really work in government-funded based healthcare systems. So UK, Canada, Australia, Mideast, and Europe. So we are looking for acquisitions that can be tucked in that do fill gaps in our offerings, and we know what those gaps are. So we are looking for them that way. But again, we're very fiscally oriented based organization as well. So we want to make sure we're hitting the numbers that we have to.
I mean, and are you seeing big opportunities for consolidation in a market like this?
Yeah, our investment thesis when we started this, 6 years, 7 years back, was that there was an opportunity for consolidation because we do think that a lot of the smaller vendors do cater to those geographies, but they're really landlocked in terms of what their opportunities are. So they really deal with their geographies. So there's opportunities where we can move those and put those together as one cohesive group. So we really get the broader marketplace and get that more organic growth for those organizations together.
I mean, and just taking a look at some recent news flow, this week, you announced a multi-year contract with Buckinghamshire, Oxfordshire and Berkshire. That's for integrated care systems in those counties. And earlier this month, also taking your Synopsis digital preoperative platform into the Canadian market. So lots of news happening at the moment.
Yeah, we're consistently adding, you know, organic growth. Although we grow through M&A, we looked at something called annual recurring revenue, which is really the annual amount that we get from all of our recurring customer bases, which has now exceeded over $30 million in revenue to go do that. So recurring revenue is, so we're consistently adding new deals. We grow organically between 500,000 and 1.5 million on a quarterly basis in terms of what we announce. So these are just another two examples of thing that we expect to see, you know, consistent growth with. The Bob deal, the Buckshire deal, is again an expansion of our transforming systems line, a product called Shrewd, which has grown really nicely through the UK, where it looks at a regional view. So we look at a population grouping of, say, 2-3 million people, and we look at all those facilities to support that, and we can see dashboards and real analytics of how those organizations are performing on an integrated view on a population basis. So that's, again, another region that grew within there that expanded to that. Synopsis is an example of our ability to grow outside of the UK market by moving those products internationally. So we moved the Synopsis product, which again is a newer product that we have in the UK, which helps with preoperative based assessments before you come in for elective surgeries. We don't see a product like that in Canada. So we made a conscientious decision to move that into the Canadian marketplace. That product has had success in the UK, and again, just evidence of our ability to move it across different geographies.
So tell us about your reason to start trading on OTCQX. I think you started trading middle of June, and the reception you've had from investors in the US.
The markets have been a little bit harsh over the last little while, but we did feel there was a need to move our base within Canada to the US base. We think it was a good investment opportunity for US investors that might not get visibility into something like that we have in Canada, just based on the nature of what we did. So we moved it there. We've done a series of meetings over the last little while with US investors, and they do seem to be receptive to the story. So it is mission accomplished, and we do want it to broaden our base so that we can increase our awareness in the investor community.
Well, it sounds like a good story for investors. Dan, thank you very much for introducing us to the company today. I hope you'll be speaking again in the near future.
Steve, thanks for having us today, and we look forward to doing more interviews in the future.
That's Dan Matlow. He's the CEO of VitalHub.